टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग एग्जांपल ऑफ प्रिंसिपल पोजिशन मोमेंटम अनसर्टेनिटी. फर्स्ट एग्जांपल इज हाइजेनबर्ग गामा रे माइक्रोस्कोप. नाउ वी विल ट्राई टू ऑब्जर्व द पोजिशन ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रॉन विद अ माइक्रोस्कोप ऑफ वेरी हाई रिजॉल्विंग पावर. ऑप्टिकल थ्योरी टेल्स अस दैट द लिमिट ऑफ रिजोल्यूशन डिपेंड्स अपॉन द वेवलेंथ ऑफ लाइट यूज टू इल्यूमिनेट द इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड इज गिवन बाय डेल्टा एक्स लैम्डा अपॉन 2 साइन थीटा. लेट अस सपोज वी गिव दिस इक्वेशन एज इक्वेशन नंबर 1, वेयर डेल्टा एक्स रिप्रेजेंट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट्स which can be resolved by the microscope, hence it represents the uncertainty in determining the position of the particle. To minimize the uncertainty, we must use the radiations of shortest wavelength such as gamma rays. But the use of gamma rays involves the Compton effect, where the electron experiences recoil. In order to observe where the electron is, one of the incident photon must strike and the electron and scatter into the microscope. When the photon bounces off into the microscope, it transfers momentum for the electron. The amount of momentum transferred being uncertain due to finite aperture of the microscope. The scattered photon can travel anywhere in the cone of illuminating of the objects. The uncertainty in momentum of the electron can be calculated as follows. This in the next diagram we see that this is an incident photon. Now photon, this is electron. Photon after collision, this is scattered photon. So let us first take photon of momentum h nu upon c, strikes the electron initially at rest so that its initial momentum is zero. The striking photon transfers the momentum mv to the electron and scatters into the microscope. Now according to principle, the conservation of momentum along x-axis, this is equal to h nu upon c, this is equal to h nu dash upon c cos alpha plus mv cos beta. So that the component of momentum along x-axis transferred by the photon to an electron is given by px, we can say that px. So px is equal to mv cos beta. Okay. Px, suppose Px is mv cos theta, so we can write Px is equal to mv cos theta, which is equal to what? H nu upon c into h nu minus h nu dash upon c cos alpha. So Px finally will be h upon c into nu minus nu dash cos alpha. The limit of angle alpha within the microscopes are clearly from 90 minus theta to 90 plus theta. And so the spread in the x component of momentum will be given by h upon c nu minus nu dash cos 90 minus theta is less than or equal to px is less than or equal to h upon c nu minus nu dash cos 90 plus theta, or we can say that this is equal h nu upon c nu minus nu dash sin theta, because cos 90 minus theta is minus sin theta. This is less than or equal to px, or this is less than or equal to h upon c nu upon nu dash sin theta. Now therefore the uncertainty in momentum is given by px is equal to h upon c nu minus nu dash sin theta minus h upon c nu minus nu dash sin theta. और दिस इज इक्वल टू एच न्यू अपॉन सी प्लस एच न्यू डैश अपॉन सी साइन थीटा माइनस एच न्यू अपॉन सी प्लस एच न्यू डैश अपॉन सी साइन थीटा दिस इज इक्वल टू एच न्यू डैश अपॉन सी साइन थीटा और दिस वी कैन से अप्रॉक्सीमेटली इक्वल टू 2h on lambda into sin theta. So now delta x into delta px, we can say that delta x we have written as lambda upon 2 sin theta and delta px is 2h upon lambda into sin theta. So this is approximately equal to h. Now it states that the product of the uncertainty of the x component of momentum of the electron and the uncertainty in the position along x axis is of the order of Planck's constant, which is greater than h cross upon 2. So in this case we have delta x upon delta px, which is greater than or equal to h cross upon 2. Hence the experiment shows that the validity of Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Thank you.